Hey, you know what we haven't talked about yet? What we were talking about in the office about Tara Reid and all that.
All right. Her show, Terrible. What is it called?
Taradise.
Taradise?
Terrifying.
Oh, it's so bad. It's
ooh, it's the old Wild On show they used to do on E.
Same thing where
but
they
now
send
Tara
her around.
Reid Wild On E or whatever.
Yeah, and Brooke Burke used to talk all the time, you know, and do like the whole segments. And she's so bad. They have like 17 montages. And they'll just come to her, you know, this is where life began. And she's like, wow, you guys, that's amazing. That's crazy. This is insane.
I took a peek the other day. I couldn't believe how awful she looked.
And she won't do anything either. This is like Paris saying, no, that's crazy. You guys.
Yeah, she's in like these faraway places and she's supposed to participate in some activities and she doesn't.
No, she won't. But the two episodes I've seen, anything that they're doing, she was supposed to run with the bulls.
No.
No. I was gonna, and then I was just like, I'm not gonna. You know, it's just like, it's like, how are you building a show around this?
Oh, God.
And then she'll laugh like, camel unfilters.
Yeah, she's known for just smoking like crazy, and she had what do they call that voice when they want it to sound like it's something sexy?
Oh, that
smoky voice.
Yeah, no. Demi Moore description.
Yeah. There's a way you put it that sounds sexy. And maybe when a few years back, when she was doing those American Pie movies, I guess it was kind of cute. Now it's just reached a point where it really reminds me of Lucille Ball. In her final years when she used to do Carson. Remember you watch I Love Lucy as a kid and she was like, Ricky, we got to have Mrs. Trumbull watch Little Ricky and I'll meet you at the club later. And that was Lucy. And then, like...
6 years later.
6 years go by. She's on a talk show. Well, you know, me and Viv, when we invented the sitcom, we never really got along with Bill Frawley. When me and Desi started Desi Lou Studios, like what happened to her voice?
She'd be on those talk shows with a drink and a cigarette.
The drink
no
clinking,
problem.
Clink clink. Oh, Johnny, just drinking and smoking.
That is.
And that's definitely the road Tara Reid is taking. She's not gonna be able to talk.
The emphysema.
Yeah, they all wound up getting it back then. She died of it. Ricky, I remember seeing Desi Arnaz on a Saturday Night Live episode, like right before he died. Yeah, he was on. I don't know, did he host it? I think he was a host, and just ravaged by the sea, the big casino, got his lungs because they were always smoking. In the office, we were talking about the episodes of I Love Lucy where they would do product placement for Philip Morris. It was a cigarette company that sponsored the show. And Lucy would offer people cigarettes that came over the house in a candy dish full of cigarettes that were on the table of a TV show. They'd be like wafts of smoke on the set. You know, the whole studio probably just stunk. The set had nicotine dripping down the walls. You have to squeegee off the camera lenses.
And Tara Reid's starting to sound like...
Mr. Mooney, we're here in Pamplona, Spain. Oh, I'm not going to run with the bulls.
It's crazy. Guys.
Well, I think we have some Tara audio here.
Yeah?
Let's listen to this. Water activities.
I went on this other raft thing. It was called a fly fish. And it's like this thing where everyone kind of lays down in it. And it just flies up in the air. And me and Paris is screaming like... We're so scared. It was so high that I thought it was going to flip over the other way. I think I broke my teeth and my eyeballs. Oh my God. Honestly, we really hurt each other. And I think my leg is broken. I have black and blues on my legs right here. It's crazy. But it was so much fun.
Crazy.
We did every water sport you could possibly imagine. We burnt more calories just doing water activities and not even running here. It's like we worked out for an hour. You do this every day, you'd be ripped.
Wow. People are watching this shit.
She's got one of those voices. It's just
around every few words. Stop talking. Then we went on this thing. It's called The Fly. It's fantastically fun.
Like her voice just cuts out.
It's like a cell phone call.
Here we are in Australia. It's wonderful. We're by the reef.
Just cuts out. Not getting a signal. Good signal. Sultry, people are saying the voice is called.
Sultry.
Sultry.
Sure. Mike on Long Island. What's up, Mike?
Hey, I caught a glimpse of that show the other day. It is the most full show on TV. All she talked about is how exclusive she's getting into, and you got to hear her refer to herself in person. This is the Tara Zone or the Reed Zone. This is like exclusive.
Hey, stop ripping off Anthony. Anthony came up with the voice that just, craps out.
His phone. He's got Tara voice phone.
All right, Mike, thank you. Here's another clip.
It was hysterical. My camera crew comes in, and then all these other camera crews, flashes everywhere. We're like, what is going on? It all happened at once. And Paris and Paris were like, wow, she's a big crew.
Say hi to the camera.
I'm sitting there like, who are all these people? It all happened so quick. There's like 8 cameras, 25 paparazzi all around the table, and it was just like, whoa.
That's your only camera. Paris, that's the only camera allowed in.
You know, and then finally we got everyone else out, but we kept ours in.
They figured it out. The bodyguards figured it out.
You nailed the voice, man.
She's got it, and oh.
She tells the worst story.
Yeah.
We were like, wow.
And I go, awesome, we got a bigger crew in Paris Hilton.
Who cares? Wasn't the whole thing with the original show is that it was her going to bars, like party locations?
Yeah.
And then what, did they run out of bars? Because now they try to make it more than it really is. Where she's actually trying to get culture some of these places.
I have no idea.
Oh, my God. Oh, so good. Oh, my God, I'm an orgasm.
Oh, no.
Honey and cheese, like, fried. I love Greek food. This is out of control.
Oh, my God. I've never in my life tasted anything better. Like, we were flipping out. It was sick. It was amazing. It was so, so good.
She has, like, 3 adjectives in her whole vocabulary.
Sick. It was amazing.
So, so good.
You need a show to have somebody tell you how delicious some food product was? That's what she's talking about.
I never realized her voice was so fucked up.
All raspy.
The other thing is, it all of a sudden just speeds up out of nowhere.
Yeah. She loves the cigarettes, is what it is. She must be a mess to, like, wake up in the morning for the next show. Just picture sprawled out on the bed in some hotel room, with jizz on the sheets, and just reeking of smoke.
Jizz in her hair.
Everything she owns must just reek of cigarette smoke. Just her hair all in disarray, her face all swollen from the night partying.
What? I need another hour. No, call me later. I got sleep.
Punching the mirror, getting in a karate fight.
Saigon. I can't believe I'm still in Saigon. And then the Viet Cong came in from the north. I was like, wow.
This is the end.
First and ninth air cab, air mobile.
I was going to blow this off, but we have to hear more of her.
It's horrible.
Of her speech.
Oh, I'm over.
Paris and Paris couldn't have been any kinder. You know, they just took us in and showed us the other side of Greece that we wouldn't have ever gotten to know. We were dancing and singing together. I mean, there's just so much love there. Paris and Paris, they're truly eating up. I think it's beautiful.
Truly what?
Paris and Paris, they're truly just...
truly just beautiful.
She hacks up a tumor.
I think people are going to see I'm not just a party girl, but I care about people. And I'm kind of goofy and I have a funny side to me, too. Insane. What is that?
That's the Acropolis, and the main building is the Parthenon.
And what is that?
This is a monument from the...
So is he one of the gods? Like Hercules?
No, that's mythology. This is the real thing. It was the golden age of Heracles, built 2,500 years ago.
So he was a god?
Yes.
See, I'm confused. Did you know this? See, you guys don't know either, so don't make me look really stupid. He was the guy that built that, right?
Like, he was like the governor back then. And that's how democracy started.
Is he the guy that did the thing with the potatoes? He was like, right, that guy was a leader. He ruled Greece, and there was no potatoes. And he wanted the economy to be better. I'm learning way too much stuff. Is that like when the ruins were?
Exactly.
Okay, see, I'm getting smarter by the minute. It was one of the birthplaces of civilization, and it was amazing.
Amazing.
We should stick to the good clubs.
Yeah, let's talk about the clubs.
Yeah, I'm sounding worse than Jessica Simpson right now. She's looking like a rock scientist.
Holy. I don't know.
I'm learning too much stuff.
Trying to get a history lesson. I don't think that part of the show is very good.
Do you hear the sound effects? They actually make fun of her because...
Yeah. Boing.
Because she's so stupid.
See, like, the one with the potatoes?
That's the one with the potatoes. Because I know that it was a leader, and he has people, and they ran out of potatoes, and I got to get some more potatoes. Is that the guy? Is that the guy? What is it? Give me a fucking drink. I need a drink.
Fabulous.
Yeah, Justin, Tennessee, what's up?
Not much. What's going on, fellas?
You tell us.
Okay, I'm wondering, are the networks just looking for the biggest idiots to do these shows nowadays?
Yes, pretty much.
Okay, because, I mean, MTV has Ashley Simpson, and she's the biggest no-talent ass clown I've seen ever. And, I mean, Tara Reid, they just put a camera in front of her and a drink in her hand and call it a show.
TV is all about just finding train wrecks now.
Got to make this about me.
We have Tara Reid on the phone. Tara!
Hi, boys.
Hey, Tara.
Wow, you sound sexy with that voice.
What's up, Tara Reid?
I was out all night partying with ass. Hey, a bunch of my friends were telling me you guys were talking about me. So what's going on?
What's up, Tara?
I like when they call that have no material.
Yeah.
Hi, it's Tara Reid. Again, having to say who it is. And then...
Well, it had potential. Yeah. One more clip of Tara.
That's unbelievable. Yeah, we like to eat dinner at least 3 times a day. Yeah, we can tell. I'm going to be a monster by the end of it.
Hello.
I need to honestly get my mouth stapled and just talk out of a straw. That's all I do is eat. I'm getting fatter by the second. I'm going to need a girl. Forgetting about me in a bikini, I'm just a monster now. I told myself that. Have you ever seen me this big in your life?
I have no idea what she said.
And she just laughs
about being fat, bikini.
I think it's
fat,
like
bikini. Food.
If we keep eating, I'm gonna get huge in my bikini. I'm not gonna be able to fit into it. Because I keep eating, I'm gonna have to get my mouth to eat through a straw.
She didn't even say that. She said breathe through a straw or something.
I don't know. Talk through a straw.
It's like, isn't it getting your jaw wired shut and eating through a straw? She's like getting my mouth stapled and talking through a straw. She gets everything wrong. She was confusing Greek mythology with the potato famine.
And then the god Apollo needed french fries and he couldn't find any. So he had to like get a Peristophocles guy and he came down and actually got them curly fries.
That's
you
amazing.
Dope. What a dolt.
That's fucking unbelievable. I can't book anything. And she's
on
walking
television.
Into the audition.
You got to be a train wreck, Bill.
I just got this ad yesterday. I didn't have time. You guys.
She's on TV.
There it is. Guy has a show. People talk about it. People watch it.
Encore. One more clip.
Of course.
Talking about food. More food.
What is going on with the potatoes and the bread? I mean, guys, are you trying to make me fat by the second? I'm not eating them. Guys, my ass is jiggling. You can't starve yourself and be like a typical actress that doesn't eat and do a movie that we did because it was too intense. Do you know what I mean? So, literally, you ate what you could. So, we ate stuff just for energy, but it was food. So, we got fat.
Yeah, hence the look.
But we'll get it off.
Yeah, you passed the Greek salad. That's really good.
It's them eating and talking about
getting fat.
Getting fat from eating shitty
TV,
food.
Honey.
But like, the movie is like so intense. I did American Pie. The dry place that I had to go as an actress. It's so hot. I mean, eating food here is so cheap food. I got fat. You know, it was different on the set of my motion picture, Josie and the Pussycats. We had such great food there. Now it's such horrible.
Michael Jordan from Alabama writes, Tara Reid actually said rock scientist instead of rocket scientist.
Rock scientist?
Yeah, I did hear that.
Fantastic.
Rock scientist.
She is the greatest.
All right.
I'm looking forward to the next program. We need more Tara clips.
Yeah?
Please put that on the list.
You want to do some Tara things?
Yeah.
All right, Tara clips on the way for you, Anthony.
I got a fart was inside me. That was amazing. And they were looking at me. I was like, you guys. I was with this guy once, and all of a sudden, I thought I had a fart, and it was an inside fart, and it almost came out. And then I did fart, and it came out as a smoke ring. And everyone laughed and laughed. And I didn't know I could blow smoke rings. And I farted, and the last cigarette I had was like 15 minutes ago, and I still had a smoke ring.
Derek and the gang are loving the new impression, the new Anthony impression. Who knew you could do Tara, Anthony?
Who knew?
Who knew?
Horrible whore.
Guys, Tara Dice.
Never do that.
Tara Dice is the greatest show on TV.
Tara Dice.
See, if we had a TV pitch like this, we would be on A&E at this point.
How would the pitch go?
Okay, drunk whore.
We got this drunk whore.
Think drunk whore meets around the world. Yeah. We need drunk whore meets... Yeah.
Lifestyles of the rich and famous.
Ooh, very good.
Hey, there you go.
I was thinking that other more obscure show of that guy that just goes around the world and stops.
Branson?
Champagne wishes caviar drinks. Champagne wishes caviar drinks.
But anyway,
give me another drink.
I think this was like the latest Rolling Stone magazine or something. They talked to good old Tara Reid, who's just a drunken whore. This is the last hurrah for her.
Yeah.
This is how it ends for Tara Reid, by the way. Tara Dice is like the Citizen Kane of trashy late night basic cable party shows. An e-tour of the horrible, fabulous life of Tara Reid.
Who's Citizen Kane?
The star of Body Shots sloshes around the world, boozing it up in Monte Carlo, stumbling on yachts in St. Troy, slurring, I need to get some ass, or I think Sardinia is paradise.
Paradise.
Paradise is full of precious moments with Tara as a goodwill ambassador, spreading her loving arms around the globe. When somebody mentions the London terrorist bombings, Tara steps right up. And this is what she had to say about that.
Of course she does.
If all the mean people want to be mean to each other, buy a country together, and just blow each other up. Then there'd be no terrorists left. But, like, don't kill innocent people for no reason. It's not fair. It makes me sad.
Can you imagine trying to, maintain an erection as you're talking? Like, you got her back to her apartment.
Babbling.
Like, I'm going to bang this girl. And she's like, yeah, you should do about terrorism.
It's awful. Have to buy an island all together, and they can all get on it. What we're going to do is get Al-Qaeda on one island. It's what we're going to do is get them all together, and they'll blow each other up. That's what they're going to do. I believe I heard one of my advisors said this. Was it one of my advisors? We're going to get them. We're going to put them on an island and blow it up, and then all the evil will be gone in the world. Where did I hear that? It was either advisor or paradise. When was it? I can't recall. We gotta make sure she commits herself against terrorism. I'm calling her a terrorist. It's so awful to watch.
Well, this is one of our favorite things. It's one of our favorite new things, playing Tara clips.
Because she
is
just a drunk whore.
We got a couple things here. She was in Croatia.
What?
Croatia.
Oh, my God, you
Paradise
guys.
Made it to Croatia.
You guys.
There's these Brazilian dancers and belly dancers, and people were doing these like bongo things, and all of a sudden, you know, we're dancing and having a great time.
They're doing their bongo things. Ricky, Mr. Mooney was there, and Viv, I locked myself in the bank vault, and Mr. Mooney's coming.
I like that she doesn't even, everything's just a thing. You just get basically the word of what it is.
Bongo thing. And then Space Shuttle Technology. I was doing like this space thing.
Hey, who wrote this? You, Nathaniel?
It was like, wow. We drove around. It was like in a wheel thing with a motor thing. And it took us to this party thing. Oh.
The next clip, Anthony and Nathaniel wrote, Tara bores America with a story. That was the pitch. That was the pitch for the show. That's the side of the bus.
When I first got here in Croatia, the beginning part was all work. I had to do a huge photo shoot for the cover of FHM. So we went to this little island. It was about an hour and a half boat ride to get to where we had to get to. On the way there, they did my hair and then we did my makeup and we picked out what clothes we were doing. So the time we got there, everything was ready set up. And I was a little nervous. I was in all bikinis. I was like, oh God, I hope I look okay. But I saw the pictures and I think it's going to come out pretty good.
This is why they're sending her around the world.
Yeah.
This is why she is on an aircraft going to different places in the world so she can get on a boat and have her makeup done and tell everybody about it.
And I've been waiting years for TV to get to this point.
Trainwreck
TV. You're just going to see more and more of this crap now.
You know, they've said about reality programming that there's no like redeeming value or quality to any of these shows. This truly offers nothing. This show offers abso-fucking-lutely nothing to the viewer.
They even edit it to just making fun of how fucking awful she is.
Yeah, you heard them clip something out of there.
Of course. Tara Reid quotes, where do we get this from? Travis just handed this in. These are actual Tara Reid quotes. But
at the end of a movie, all my outfits are missing. They even call Tara, those are $700 shoes. What are they going to do, search my house?
So I guess she was pilfering from her wardrobe?
Yeah.
All her, like, stories, like, the listeners just, like, in panic, like, oh, my God, it's my turn.
Yeah.
I have to say something. Like, that just ends, like, mid-idea.
She's talking about, what is this?
I don't like the typical good-looking guy. I know this sounds ridiculous, but I like a guy with love handles. When he doesn't care 100% about his body, I don't have to obsess about mine. I hate washboard stomachs. It does not turn me on.
Wow.
Well, seeing some of her shots in the bikini, I could see why. If the guy doesn't look good, she doesn't have to look good. Did you see those stomach shots?
You got to read the next one.
I hate being tickled. Sure, it makes me laugh, but when I get tickled, I get pissed off. I'm like a monkey when I get tickled. Woohoo.
And they spelled out woohoo.
Woohoo, Robin.
Tell him, Fred.
Tell him, Fred. Oh. The chocolate's coming faster down the conveyor belt than I can make put it in the box.
Do the Bloody Mary. You just got to go down. These are just amazing.
I just started making Bloody Marys. I always thought they looked gross, and then I tasted one. There's an art to it, from the Tabasco to the Worcestershire.
It's
like an art. From the Tabasco to... Indeed, Tara, there is truly an art to it.
By the way, people, this is real.
Yeah.
These are real quotes. I know we're really good at making fun of shit. This is real stuff that we're just reading.
I like when a guy makes me feel like a woman and a little girl at the same time.
All at the same time.
Hey there, princess. Suck my dick.
I'm not perfect. I do drink. I do smoke. Carson Daly can't go out and get messed up. He can't smoke in front of kids. He's the face of MTV. He's got to be good. But me, I can.
You know, Carson was
smoking in front of children.
You know, Carson Daly was obviously onto something.
Yeah.
Because a lot of people are like, why are you dumping this piece of ass? Because there was a time she was pretty hot.
She was a catch.
I guess he saw the signs early.
Does she just like go down to Chuck E. Cheese and like start smoking? Get out of the fucking ball pit, you little cocksuckers. Try this. Scattle non-filter.
Do the last one about slasher movies.
Slasher movies are fun. You watch yourself get chopped to pieces, yet you're still alive. You see blood on the axe and think, holy shit, this is sick. But you kind of get over your fear of death.
Your fear of fake death.
She gets over her fear of fake death.
What a boob. What a complete boob this girl is.
All right, here's more from Tara Reid. Tara saying cheers in multiple languages.
So we get to Hvar Island, and we went to this little place, little village called Starigrad, and it was absolutely beautiful. It was like a hidden treasure.
Jubilee.
Chin chin.
Jubilee.
Chin
chin. We said all, every language we've been to so far.
Yeah, okay, so, well, I don't know if we can
see. Cheers, slanche, how do you say it in Italian?
Chin 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 chin.
Chin chin?
Chin chin and chin chin.
That's not Greek. It's English.
Chin chin. Isn't that a Chinese restaurant?
That's just
chin,
English. Chin chin.
Chin chin.
Chin chin.
Chin chin.
Slanche. Cheers. And Jiberle.
Everyone should eat at Antica.
No, that means antiques.
Gunga Lagunga. Gunga. Gunga Lagunga. Is what the Dalai Lama said to me. Gunga Gunga Lagunga. So I got that going for me, which is nice. Big hitter, the llama.
What an idiot. Just him. Out there representing America.
You guys like to hear more of her?
Oh, yeah.
All right.
This is
Tara messing with press.
Is it possible that we get drinks? And we finally clear everyone out, and we're dancing on the tables, and everyone's going crazy when we dance on the tables, and they start dancing on the tables.
Someone on the table? What happened?
Something about a table, table.
Something a table.
Table.
How annoyed would
table,
you be?
You were next to a table.
You're out.
You're sitting at a table.
You're
table.
Just trying to have some fun, and here's some drunk whore, Tara Reid, dancing on your fucking table.
But we're watching.
You'd have to throw something at our head.
Love the train wreck shit. Love it.
Dancing on the table.
You know where the gate was when we walked in, the bridge? Is it true or is it just like in movies? Was there like crocodiles and stuff in there? If you got in, like you got pushed in, you'd get killed?
No. Okay. We don't have crocodiles.
You hear that?
Where were they?
Yeah,
they were probably somewhere where there wasn't crocodiles.
They had to cross over a moat.
Across the moat of the crocodile, like she's getting her information from fucking cartoons.
Did he dress like that guy from Burger King?
Fucking retard.
Is there a moat? In the moat, and you got to get across it on a little raft with a sail, and then you pick a fan up, and you plug the fan in, and blow it on the sail, and you go across the moat, and then you get a big barrel of TNT and put it by the gate, and then you go back and light it, but the rabbit already lit it while you were rocking backwards, and then it blows you up, and then you got to go all the way back to the ship and get another match. And you try to light the big pot with the rabbit in it, but the rabbit blows it out, and you got to go back. And even a kid knows, why didn't he bring more than just one match? Because he keeps going back for the match.
What do you do when the dragon shows up? The car starts breathing fire, and you're like, whoa.
You know, you raise, like, you go, raise the drawbridge, and, like, the dragon's coming, and you raise the drawbridge. And we were dancing on the tables. And then you get over your fear of death because it's like, real, but a dragon doesn't exist. I was like, wow. And I went into the powder room and I thought it was gunpowder, but all of a sudden it turned into like there were mirrors and powder in there.
I like sucking the cock of a fat guy because I don't like a washboard meal. It makes me feel better about myself.
This is just endless.
So we were eating, and I ordered the duck, and it was like, I didn't know how they got it. Like, it was rabbit season or duck season. Rabbit season, duck season, fire. And they shot him, and his beak went on his head.
And you're getting a request. I'm just going to throw it out there.
Oh, God.
Can you do Tara doing Steve-O, doing Scott Farrell, picking sports games? We had three things on the show today that sound very similar.
And it's all the same thing.
It really is.
Jesus Christ, I love this show.
Let's go with more clips here.
You know where the gate was when we walked in, the bridge? Is it true or is it just like in movies? Was there like crocodiles and stuff in there? If you got in, like you got pushed in, you'd get killed?
No. Okay. We don't have crocodiles.
No, you idiot.
You hear the song.
But she's literally laughing like, yeah, I know, I'm an idiot. Just give the information.
All right, here's a new clip.
Peter had an amazing voice, and he's very sexy. You know, he's a good-looking guy, and, you know, singing Croatian, a guy singing Croatian to me with beautiful face. I mean, it's pretty cool. I was like this. I was in awe.
Isn't that cute?
So are we.
Yeah.
gets around to eat travel paradise.
She requested a separate room.
At a hotel?
At a hotel for
her shoes.
Her shoes. Which cost an additional $3,700 a night. That sounds like one of those publicity things.
That's just dumb diva shit. That means nothing. All right, here we go. Tara described, she's described as the female Joe Cocker. Oh, no.
What?
Go get a Joe Cocker song ready, Derek.
Why?
So I sang back to him, but God only knows what I sing. I don't even know what I was doing. I'm pure retarded. I hope they don't show that.
Okay,
I can't sing anymore.
Oh.
My voice is broken.
No, it's broken. Like I told her, she sounds like a female Joe Cocker.
Joe Cocker.
I get by with a little help from my friend. I'm feeling all right. Oh, my God, you guys, I'm singing. Where's my shoe? Every night, I had the same dream over and over again. In prison, by the way, I could have been left you on my own. So it seems. Get to the hook, guys. It's too many words. So why do songs have to be so wordy? All right. But everyone around me feels like shit.
Does have a kind of a Joe Cocker tone to her voice.
You guys want more?
No, what would you do if I sang out of tune, you guys?
Yeah, we got any more? Sure.
Yeah.
Love the Tara.
All right, she's in Sardinia.
Where is that?
I have no idea.
Is that where they put the little fish in the cans? You got to open a key? Hate Sardinia.
Where is it? Off Italy. Thank you.
Italy.
I'm at the beach now, Porto Polo, which I think it means chicken beach. And there's supposed to be like professional windsurfers and kite surfing. And there's a million people behind me doing it. And I want to meet these really cute boys, Barney and Jason, and they're going to show me.
Barney and Jason.
All right, she sounds kind of normal there.
Yeah, it's before she got hammered.
Yay.
In the morning.
Blew my first kite. That was really scary. You almost killed someone. You know that, right? Look, they're all, look at them. They're all running away. Seriously? Almost killed all of them. Then they started yelling, da 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 da, whatever it was at the time. But I know it wasn't nice.
That is
oh, my God. There's no way I'm flying on that thing. There's not even a chance. Not happening. Not happening. It's so crazy.
That's the thing I think Bill pointed this out, is that they show her all these cool activities, and then she refuses to do
them.
She
doesn't do any of them.
So now all they're left is we're just going to make fun of how fucking stupid you are, because that's all we have in the footage.
He makes a good point, because the next clip is Tara practicing windsurfing on beach, refuses to try it on water.
She doesn't do anything.
How could you...
The running of the bulls.
I'm going to be doing that in like 20 minutes. Oh, my God, you guys, this is crazy.
And then they cut to her. She's like,
oh, my God, there's like no way I'm doing that.
And then you just cut to her in a bar, drunk.
Everybody's dancing. I was dancing. People were running. It was insanely crazy. Like, I wasn't going to do it.
Well, she doesn't do any of the things.
I'm much too drunk.
Yeah, she literally goes. The whole purpose of going to is to get involved
to
in the
do these things. Yeah.
Go to China, Great Wall of China.
I'm not going up all the steps. I don't want to. I'm tired. I'm going back to the hotel.
Well, here she is practicing windsurfing on the beach and not in the water.
I did windsurfing on the sand, and I still couldn't do it. I was like, you know, like wiggling, jiggling, like trying to just stand. And all of a sudden, I was like, you know, like it was crazy. It was so much fun, though. I fell in the sand like 20 times. I decided that you're going to do it, and I'm going to watch you.
Come on.
I'm going to watch you. That's why we're doing it.
This is a joke, right?
No, it's true. Can you imagine being that director? She tells the story, I couldn't do it, and I fell out like 20 times. It's crazy.
Off.
And then you got to be like, and cut. You think we got that?
Is there, when do you know when to yell cut?
Yeah, and you just like you say anything.
Do we got anything? Can we use anything? Anything?
I felt like 20 times. She was talking about being on the sand
with the sailboard.
So all you have to do is stand, really.
Just, it's called standing. At that point. You're not windsurfing. You're standing on the beach.
I fell down like 20 times, you guys.
We're running out of show. Let's get a couple more clips in before we get out of here for the day.
So then me and Constantine, we go out to Billionaire, and we made such a scene walking in there. Everyone's like taking our pictures, the paparazzi, is this, that. Then they put us in this VIP room. So before you know it, I'm sitting in Constantine's lap, and we're sitting in a chair like a throne. We looked like retards, but it was hysterical. Like, I didn't even care. I was just staring at him. It was so hot.
No, you are retards.
And again, and cut. Is there anything we can use there?
Visiting Roberto Cavalli's.
Who is that?
Some fashion guy.
Oh, some fashion guy.
His boat.
Oh, my God. You don't know
which color it looks like.
Oh, my God. It's purple, blue, green. Look at pink, purple, red now. Oh, my God. Gold. It's gold, Dad. Look at it. Yellow, orange. Wow.
Was she describing a bowl of tricks?
Wow, look at this. It's blue, it's orange, it's turning this one's turning the milk brown. It's like Cocoa Puffs, but
what is she talking about? Wow, it's gold. What was that?
She was going on the boat, I guess.
But what was she, the colors of the boat, a Ferris wheel? Got her attention?
It's the boat is designed so that it looks different colors from different angles.
Oh, it's got one of those paint schemes prism-like paint.
Put her in a rally ship, a reality show. Her, Tara Reid, and Stalker Patty. It'll be like, how do you pitch that? It's like Cagney and Lacey meet the Jerry Lewis telethon.
Oh, look at it. It's changing colors. What a dope.
That's what she got out of a boat ride.
I guess we'll
was
end
the
there.
Pretty colors.
Huh?
That's wonderful.
That's a good one?
Was there one more?
Well, we'll save it for the next time we go down this road.
Oh, I love the Taradice.
We'll visit with Tara and Taradice another time on the Opie and Anthony program, but we're done for today, man.
Yeah. How much time?
We got 4, 3, 2, 1.
4 seconds left?
0.
You said?
Hit it.
Yeah. Get party is over! Everybody go home!
We saved this because Bill hasn't been around in a while. Because we had Norton back, and then, I don't know, you've been doing your own thing, obviously.
Oh,
but
yeah.
We love the Taradice.
I've been going to places like Albany and Buffalo. I don't got time for you guys.
Exciting
I'm jet
places.
Setting to all the hot cities in New England. Portland, Maine.
Yeah, much more important than getting national exposure on this show.
Oh, exactly. Why would I want to become a draw nationally when I can perform in front of 30 people in Ottawa?
Ottawa. Did you play Ottawa?
No. Even that one was too fucking ridiculous.
Guys, we've got to get right into Taradice because we're losing time here.
Taradice has been canceled, but I guess they're pumping out the last few episodes.
Why the fuck would they cancel the show? All those wild-ons were kind of cool at first because you get to see a lot of hot asses and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But then it's like, all right, it's more of the same, whatever.
Plus, you got to watch your career flame out.
Taradice. This show was great. We loved it.
Yeah, they'd send Tara around to different places around the world for her to party.
Oh, my God, you guys.
You guys. And she would comment on various little tidbits of information about the place she was at.
Yeah.
History. Can just come out of her ass. She's in Greece. She'll talk about Greek history.
Yeah. If people are doing something exciting, she'll say that she's going to do it the whole episode, and then in the end we'd be like, it's crazy.
I was watching an episode and just laughing, thinking about you saying that because she was doing that. She's like, we're going to go surfing, it's going to be so kick-ass, we're just going to head out of the beach, there's some, like, big waves, Irish, like, big waves, that they got, like, the big boards, we're all going to get surfing down, and they get to the beach, and it's like, okay, well, let's get out there, and say, are you crazy? I'm not getting out there, there's no way I'm surfing, I'll just watch, I'll sit here on the beach.
Oh, my God, guy almost died, I mean, that guy's, like, so hot.
The best one was when she was windsurfing on the sand.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
And then saying how great it was and how much fun it was.
Yeah, when they train
she's
people.
She's going, wow.
Yeah. When they train people to windsurf, the first thing you do.
I almost fell off the earth.
How do you windsurf on the sand and it's actually fun?
The first thing they do is put you on the sand when you windsurf.
All right.
And it's just to learn how to pick the sail up and how to kind of stand on the board.
Yeah.
And that's the furthest she would go.
And she thought that was so much fun.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, this is so much fun. We're here windsurfing on the sand.
So, she was in a place I like to call Saint Tropez.
Saint Tropez.
How do you really say it?
Saint-Tropez.
Saint-Tropez, that's right.
Saint-Tropez.
I like Saint-Tropez myself.
Saint-Tropez.
So this is Paradise. Show's going away, unfortunately, but
bye-bye.
This could be the last time we do Paradise. Life is a dream. Here it is. Paradise.
Okay. Imagine having a great dream, having the best dream in your life, and all your friends were in your dream, and guess what? It's not a dream, it's real. Biggest show ever in the history of television.
Like, that should have been such, like, a dramatic, like, build-up. That almost sounded like the first time she was reading the copy.
Picture of Jay. Are you friends with that? It's not Jay. It's actually happening.
Okay, Tara, I think we got it.
Thank you.
That's a good one. We're going to use that take.
That was good.
We'll just put some slamming music behind it. Boom, 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 boom. This is Jay. Picture Jay. Picture. Boom, boom, boom. It's great, Jane. You're here, and it's just happening.
And all your friends.
And cut.
Tara's invention idea. Listen to this.
Ah.
Listen, I came up with an idea.
Yes.
And it's honestly the biggest idea I've ever come up with.
What is it?
I want at least 50% because it's my idea.
All yours. What is it?
No, I'm not kidding you. It's going to make you guys billionaires.
What is it?
It will make you billionaires.
Come on. Go ahead. Keep going.
So far on this trip, I've lost two purses. I lose my bag every day. Bert, where's my purse? Do you have it? I have no idea where my purse is. I want to make a line of bags, purses, that has a chip in it.
Tracking device.
Yep.
LoJack for bags.
Yep.
I love it.
Even hire, like operators that you call up, like OnStar.
OnStar, exactly.
You know what I mean? My purse has got stolen. Where is it?
I love
it. It's on Fifth Street and 42nd. We're getting it now. We even have people that in their cars and get the bags.
I mean, let's be realistic. You mentioned the people putting a LoJack in a purse. It sounds stupid.
Every person that has money is going to do that.
Of course.
Everyone.
Love it.
Who thought of that? Genius girl.
That's
so
true, baby.
I am the smartest girl. You guys all think I'm just a party girl. But I'm also a smart girl. I'm a smart businesswoman.
That will make billions?
Wow. It's a purse with a chip in it. And you can track it. And there's people that just drive around cities.
Operating
to pick up your purse.
We can use the Air Force. We can just, use big radar station and find my purse.
They got the chip technology already, and I'm sure people are using it for just
chains.
That.
You go beep beep.
Like the New York City Marathon happened, and if you had a loved one in the race, you could just follow their
track
progress.
Them.
Yeah, on the internet. Like, oh wow, they're still in Brooklyn, or they're crossing the bridge now. So they
what the fuck are they doing?
They
so there's basically
technology.
A satellite beam. I mean, what kind of stress is that on your body? You're running 26 miles, and you got this fucking beam coming down from outer space right into the top of your head.
We're being cut through every nanosecond of our lives by radiation from radio, TV, satellite. All that stuff is just blowing through you. Small little particles, electrons flying through you.
Nice.
If you could see those, if they were visible, we wouldn't be able to see each other. The air is so just full.
Can you
of
say
those
all
things.
That in Tara? That sounds like a Tara.
Imagine radio waves. Imagine, if you will, they're just sitting there. And if radio waves like had color to them instead of just being like clear and like clear nail polish, if they were like red, it would be like nothing but red in front of you, and we couldn't watch Paradise. It would be an awful thing. That would be like crazy. Like right now, I'm inhaling them with every drag I take on my cigarette. I'm breathing in like radio waves, and I think that's really what's hurting people, not the cigarette. So, I got on my knees talking to a party. I wouldn't be able to see it because all the radio waves.
I'm
oh my God.
Searching for that dick through all the radio waves.
There's a stiff cock in the room, and I can't find it. Because the radio waves. Oh my God, it's crazy.
Oh my God, guys, I have an idea for an invention. I'm in cigarettes, all right? I'm in cigarettes. Instead of just a filter that filters out like tar and nicotine, well, I'm going to filter out radio waves. So instead of breathing in like radio waves, you can say, and then you can look in the end of the filter, and when you see it's brown, like from the tar and nicotine, you could also like put it in your ear and listen to the radio waves that would have gone in your lungs.
And then I can still see the cock on it.
It would like, as you're puffing, you're clearing a little space just in case the radio waves get colorful and we can't see anymore. You clear a hole, like a little glory hole, for the cock to come through the radio. It's my idea. We'll patent it. I want 50% and make $1 billion.
So you think I'm just a party girl? I'm actually really smart.
I'm a genius. Moving on. Here she describes her friends.
I love seeing my friends. I love my friends so much. I really have, I got to tell you,
the best people and the best friends around me. They're all just nice people. Every one of them are. They always have a good time. They love to play. You know, they're perfect for me.
Yeah, let's see if those friends are with you after your career really.
Was there like an ounce of sincerity?
There was no passion at all in her talk about her friend. She was talking about employees and, like, you know, producers from the show, people that will be gone and she'll never see again when the show's canceled.
She's talking about the people who roll their eyes the second she fucking walks away.
Right. My good friends. They are such good friends of mine, and I call them friends because they're indeed friends.
The upstairs is half a square that looks over the dance floor. In that half a square, there's a VIP area. So we had half of the whole side of the upstairs that looked over the dance floor. I loved dancing on the pole. It was fantastic. Everyone thought I was going to fall off the pole, of course, but I loved just swirling around on it. It was like in the middle of this wall, like this dancing pole. It was the best party in San Francisco. We had the time of our lives.
She cannot describe anything. I couldn't paint a mental picture of that. It came out like a Picasso. And there's like this thing on the floor and a wall, and the VIP is half of it, and there's a pole, and I was dancing, and people thought I'd fall off, but I didn't. And it was and there was a teeter-totter and a big sphere and a thing, and it launched, and I went. And
you know what the funny thing is? You know, like 3 feet over, like the Mona Lisa is hanging there, and she totally doesn't even see it.
Oh,
it's like she's seeing all this amazing shit, and she's just like, where's the party?
Do you have an Applebee's in Rome? I want to get some potato skin. I once had I sucked a cock in Applebee's. Maybe it was at Ruby Tuesdays. They kind of had the same appetizers. I think it was right next to the Louvre.
The Louvre. I had Louvres on the back of my car window once, and it kept the sun from coming in and stuff. And there's this whole big building in Paris that just sells them there. It's called the Louvre.
And it's so much bigger than a Home Depot. It's like crazy. And all my friends are there, and I love them. I love you guys. You guys are awesome. You're my friends. We're all friends, right, guys?
Friends. All my friends are such close, tight-knit friends.
Sure they are.
Well, that was the end of...
This is Sarah. She's my best friend and my wardrobe stylist. I love her. Isn't she great?
That finishes up her trip to Saint-Tropez.
Saint-Tropez.
The Paris, UK one was the best, though.
Yeah.
Yes.
What was that one we listened to?
No, we just listened to Saint-Tropez.
Oh, I want to hear some...
The Paris, UK, and how she talks about, like, the Euro Tunnel and all that. Unbelievable.
Eurotunnel.
It starts with the Eiffel Tower, and I guess she's talking about getting engaged under the Eiffel Tower.
If you get engaged under the Eiffel Tower, your marriage lasts forever.
Really?
It's an old urban legend, but why not? I should make a sign. Will you marry me? Will you marry me?
Yeah, you got a yes. You got a yes.
Tara. You got to get down on one knee.
He said yes. He said yes. You have to get down on one knee, sir.
Come on, take a photo of me.
Yeah, look at you, see?
Here,
turn. How are you guys doing?
I get down on one knee.
Tara Reid, may I have your hand in marriage?
Yes. Our love is forever. Oh.
This guy, Mike from Ohio, a tourist right there, asked me to marry him, and I said yes. But I was like, ah! No, it was good.
I don't even know who you are, really. But I love Van Wilder.
Oh, thanks.
I just married Tara Reid. I love Van Wilder.
Forever.
Came to the Eiffel Tower and you engaged.
Yeah, no, I don't even know. No, I'm going to ruin my love forever.
Wow, that is just jaw-droppingly horrific. How could you take that off?
It's great.
I can't believe it. He asked me, this guy Mike from Ohio, he asked me to marry him underneath the Eiffel Tower. And we're going to get married underneath there when they finally finish the thing and put, like, the paneling on it. It's not done yet. Because it's there. It's just all beams.
I wish a rioting Muslim would punch her square in her fucking face. How funny it would be if they lit her car on fire with her in it.
Oh, my God, you guys. The Muslims are burning me here in Paris. This party is the hottest party ever. I can't believe you shot her. That was my best friend. What was her name? Was that Tabitha? Melissa.
I can't remember her name, but she was such a dear, close friend of mine.
And I lost my purse. In the little rioting. They lit it on fire, but I had a chip in it. They should put chips in, like, potato chips. Every time you want potato chips, you just hit the chips, and you can find the nearest vending machine.
Sorry, it's chip and a chip. It's going to be a beautiful, wonderful invention. It's going to make billions.
And the chips attaches the chips, and that's what you hold to, so you don't get that Dorito stuff in your finger.
And it comes up on the navigation system on your Escalade, and it'll come up like, you know, barbecue or ranch or, you know, onion, a garlic, potato chip. It'll tell you what type of potato chip you're going to eat.
Here we go.
All my friends.
It gets better. She's looking for submarines in this next clip.
Why?
Looking for submarines.
Let's go on this gorgeous boat and see the most beautiful sights of Paris. The lovely love world we're in. Let's sit here. When in doubt, do it like the French do. Oui, oui, Jim, Jim. To my new engagement, to Mike in Ohio. Yeah, Mike, go Buckeyes. Is that a submarine?
I didn't have submarines in the thing. I mean, a glass water boat, whatever it's called.
What? Is that a submarine? I mean a glass bottom boat, whatever.
Wow.
Is that a battleship, a dinghy, whatever, a sailboat, or what, a truck?
If I was ever married to her, I would have to choke her out every time she fucking woke up. The second she said,
what are you doing?
Rear naked sleep, crazy lady. Just watch her eyes shut and then let off, let her breathe, but she's unconscious. And every time she comes to... Just choke her out.
Yeah, just keep choking her out.
God damn, would that be great?
All right.
I'll be your tour guide today. My name is Tara Reed. We're in Paris, and that is the Louvre.
That is the Louvre.
There is so much art in the Louvre that they had to blow it over the bridge to this place. So they kept it very close to seminar.
That's funny, that is.
Once every 8 years, the Mona Lisa leaves that place, goes over that bridge, they bring it right through that door, and goes right through that window. Every 8 years. And they say, every 8 years on Halloween night, she blinks her eyes. Can you imagine? That is the Paris, Orleans, one of us.
That's the Musée d'Orsay.
The Musée d'Orsay, that's another name they call it. It was an old bus station.
This is the same.
Subway station, now it's another museum, right? You guys, that's the oldest brothel in Paris, right there. I'm going to work there later tonight. American history. That is the Sex of the City Bridge, where Carrie runs away.
I don't want her alive. I really...
How did Carson Daly date her?
Wow. Just
I met that guy a couple times. A cool guy.
I guess you just got to keep your dick in her mouth. That's probably the only way to survive the relationship.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I was out the other night.
Just keep it full. That couldn't be... Imagine you're just some poor motherfucker on a tour, and Tara Reid decides her and her camera crew are coming on, and she's the one giving the tour.
Yeah, you've been waiting your whole life to go to Paris.
Oh, I wonder what that building
change.
Is. Oh, my God, it's part of the Louvre, and every 8 years, the Mona Lisa, it goes, and that's the episode of Sex and the City. Sex and the City, wearing the mother black shoes. And it's, why? Who cares? Ugh. And the submarine.
Paris is always so crap.
Sorry. It's okay. I was just talking about submarine or, you know, septic tank, whatever.
Paris is always so crowded and so packed. So to have it by ourselves and, you know, to see Paris, I mean, we did all these, like, fun, like, silly little, like, tour things. We walked through the park, and it was beautiful. There was, like, a carousel. Then we got up, and we went up, like, and walked around the corner and went in this area. And we saw all these great paintings and artists and people drawing.
It's the mentality of... Asking like a third grader.
Not even.
What did you do on your summer vacation?
She should come home with like a picture she drew with crayon. You know, when they just have like the lines. Just
it's just a scribble.
Yeah.
Or when they say draw you and it's just two big eyes and arms that don't fit.
And they go to color in your shirt and half it goes over your face.
Goes over the lines and the face. And Stupid kids.
Here she complains about
it. I put some glitter on my macaroni. I made an ashtray with macaroni and gold paint and some glitter. I did it all by myself. It's an ashtray. And as I was making it, I filled it up.
Here she complains that her drink is too weak.
Of course it is.
First round's on me, kids. Anything martinis, champagne, whiskeys, cocktails, liqueurs, beers, and anything else you want. What do you guys want? Yeah, the cocktail's on the back.
Can I just have an Evian, please?
No, what do you want, sweetie?
Large bottle of water.
One, two, three.
Four.
What do you want, Don?
Four
large bottles of water. Can I get a peach iced tea with vodka in it? Spice it up a little. Cheers. They didn't put any, like, they measured the stuff here. It's not even like an American shot. It's like this big. You see, it was like up to here with ice in it. So it doesn't even taste like anything.
Bitching there isn't enough vodka in it.
Can you imagine if she was your girl and you actually took her to Paris and these are the comments you were making? You'd be like, I should have taken this cunt to Rhode Island.
Oh.
She's not getting there. She could have taken her to Six Flags.
Hang on, there was a carousel and we went on a roller coaster.
We should have went and looked at leaves.
You know what I mean? We went on a submarine glass bomb boat and we saw, like, we were walking and there's people drawing.
Yeah, great.
We went to Athens and we got some beers and it was crazy. They're so weak, the drinks and stuff. Oh, yeah, there were some old wrecked buildings that we drove through. I was like, what are you taking me, the ghetto? It was amazing. We had it all to ourselves the same way every other place I got to was all to myself. So really, wasn't that amazing? We went to Greece and there's this building called the Parthenon and it's just such a wreck. Why don't they clean it up? Yeah. Fix it already. It's a real fixer-upper, but for some reason they won't build on it. Excuse me, the statue is missing the arms. Poor woman. She's got, like, no arms. And I think it's a statue, like, to show that handicapped people can do things, too.
If it was an American museum, they'd have the arms on it. It'd like, be, like, totally, like, complete. That's why we gotta feel like it's the Americans, you guys. We have, like, whole statues. Like Statue of Liberty on her hat. I mean, she wouldn't even be holding the thing up if it was in Greece.
Imagine if it just had one arm. Gee. Where's my drink?
Drunk whore.
Fucking tolerance is ridiculous. She's like, she's in the same fucking watering holes as fucking Ernest Hemingway. She's like, oh, God, it's fucking weak.
You guys.
Is this weak? I hate they're so mean.
It's whiskey and iced tea. I mean, come on.
I hate, they're so mean. They're mean, evil. Oh, my God, look how bad my hair was. That looks like strings.
She's talking about the tabloids here. Looking at pictures of herself in the tabloids. Oh.
Why are they so evil? They're just mean people. It's terrible. Bad picture of Paris, too. They're just mean. You know what I wish I could do? I wish I could find the editors of, like, Inquirer of all these people. And all the mean things they do to us, I wish we could have someone follow them around like a detective and take bad pictures of them and put them in the paper every day. And they would see what it feels like. They'd be quicker to just try to ruin people's lives.
Yeah, that's what would happen.
Yeah, but she had all of the tabloids in front of her.
Yeah,
she couldn't get enough of the tabloids. Yeah. And she was going through the tabloids. I saw this. And she was looking for her picture.
Yeah, she loves when she's
because
in those.
Because these celebrities love when their picture is in these in these rags.
Yeah.
Without a doubt.
Wow.
Moving on. We're almost done here. Discussing the Eurotunnel.
My producer just told me that I have to tell you guys a really interesting fact. We are going 187 miles right now on the Eurostar underneath the English Channel. I just want you all to know that that's why the walls are black. We're in a tunnel going almost 200 miles an hour. On our way back to London. The tunnel's called the Bula Tunnel. What's the name of the tunnel? It's called the Euro Tunnel. That's hysterical. All right, that's even a funnier thing. We thought, like, you know, in New York City, you have, like, the Lincoln Tunnel, the George Washington Bridge. Here in England, this amazing tunnel is just called the Euro Tunnel.
my God.
You know what I love, too?
Oh, my God.
She's talking about tunnels, and she goes, the Lincoln Tunnel, and then the George Washington Bridge.
George Washington Bridge Tunnel.
She couldn't think of another
tunnel. Not the Holland Tunnel.
Yeah, she couldn't think of another tunnel.
I love it. I love the Brooklyn Bridge Tunnel. I go over that all the time.
And it's simply called the Euro Tunnel.
I don't know why a bridge that connects France and England is called the Euro Tunnel. Why is that? It doesn't have France or England in it. It should be the Franklin Tunnel, something like that.
She thinks it was a play on your tunnel.
Like your tunnel.
This is your tunnel.
It's everybody's tunnel. It's your tunnel.
How boring. It's called your tunnel.
What a complete dolt.
We're going like 700 miles an hour.
Like no concept of speed or anything. You're just a fucking... And she gets to go to all these places. I'm so
not
fucking
anymore.
Jealous.
They're canceling the show.
Yeah, but she got to go.
This is it. I think this is the last installment. Maybe there's one more later.
Look how the Matt Lauer, how they gave him the hacky, I'm standing on a beach clothes.
Yeah.
The baby
yeah.
blue with
well,
the khakis.
It's time for Where in the World is Matt?
He's on Easter Island.
Oh, my God, we're here on Easter Island, and I just ran into Matt Lauer. And there's a bunch of, like, rocks with big heads, like, carved in them.
I got the first round.
Where can we get a Mai Tai here? I hear they have good Mai Tais here on Easter Island. Why is it called Easter Island? Why isn't it called, like, Thanksgiving Island or something? I love holiday, like, names of holiday islands and stuff, like Tara's Birthday Island would be such a great place.
We're here at the pyramids in Egypt. We're about ready to get a scorpion ball. I'm like so fucking wasted. You know, I can't find the door. Oh, my God. If a mummy came out of there, I would, like, so free. You guys are my friends. I love you. I'm about to take my top off. I think I can get some really good sun on my hair. Oh, my God. Can you, like, slide down the pyramid? That would be awesome. Would they put, like, a water slide up there?
I'm going to do it.
That's my idea.
I'm going to do it.
That's my idea. Give me 50% of it. You think I'm some dumb whore? Oh, she's a genius.
No, I'm not going to slide down that thing. I'm not going to. I'm not going to do it. That looks dangerous.
You guys, it's crazy. It's crazy.
That would be insane. I'll let my friends do it. I'm not going to do it.
Some people are suggesting they could have just taken her to Epcot and Disney and let her loose and like,
yeah. We're here in the France Pavilion, and I'm here, and in like 3 minutes, I'm going to walk over to Japan.
You know what? It really is a small world after all.
It is a small world. We're going over to Ireland, and I'm going to get some Guinness, and then we're going to Japan, I'm going to drink some sake, and then we're going to Mexico for some tricycles.
Oh my God, I just saw you in France.
We're here on a monorail and we're doing like 10 billion zillion miles an hour. Why can't you drink in this fucking joint?
On the instant feedback, a lot of people pointing out that she said glass water boat.
Glass water boat?
Oh. Can I have a Walt just, Disney on ice?
She's just saying whatever she sees.
Right.
Yeah. Is this a glass water fish boat?
Glass water fish tree boat.
My God, is this like a car rubber plastic?
You're just like you can't see anything because it's all flashes. So you're just like it's like blinding, you know. You're just like, and you see spots everywhere afterwards. You're like, you know, like hi, like you look like a retard. You don't know what's happening, and then they get mad at you too when you're not looking in the right angle for the camera. You're like, you know.
That's her describing the red carpet. She's on the red carpet.
Oh, the red carpet.
Is it any wonder her titty was out that long and she didn't notice?
Like, yeah.
Now I believe she didn't notice.
Yeah, but you know what's funny?
At first I thought it was a publicity stunt, like, hey, this will get me, get people talking. But now I believe she just didn't notice.
Not like I thought she was a genius beforehand, but I mean, I thought she was like, you know, moderately intelligent. You can just never tell until
they're babbling like this.
Oh, my God, you guys, you know, they belong to an exclusive club that we just don't belong to, and now they're coming for your Social Security.
Carson Daly's looking pretty good now.
Yes.
A lot of people, when he broke up with her, what are you thinking, Carson?
Yeah, what are you thinking? Now we all know what he was thinking.
Now we all know.
Oh, my God.
He saw this first.
I got to wake up
in
the morning
him in
with
here.
This.
See how the fuck he went out with her for that long? You going to marry that?
Woo. Rise and shine, sunshine, rise and shine. Here's my Carson, baby. Wake up, baby. Wake up. What do you do? What do you want for breakfast? Mimosas or bloodies? What are we drinking today?
Cigarettes still going from the night before.
She's putting cigarettes out in like crepes from room service. And stuff. just this no class whore in the hotel yelling at the fucking poor guy that brings the room service.
But I asked for the omelet, a Western omelet. Fucker.
Where is it? Just breathing smoke breath. She wakes up in the morning, hasn't had a cigarette in hours, and the first thing she exhales is smoke. She could blow smoke rings after not smoking for hours.
My brother dated a girl one time, and they were standing. It was like right at like dusk. You ever see that when the sun and the moon are out at the same time?
Yeah.
And she's like, what? How can they both be out? Literally thought it was the same fucking thing. And he just went like, oh, my God.
Holy crap.
How could that work if we're like at the center of the universe resting on a tortoise's back? How can the sun and the moon... If you go to the, we're going to take the glass water boat and reach the edge of the earth and look at the sea serpents. The world is flat. And Christopher Columbus discovered America on the three ships, the Manny, Moe, and Jack, and found like the fountain of youth. And now we're going to go look for something, and that's how they invented Columbus Day.
I hate to say it, guys, but this could be the last Paradise Club.
Oh, damn it.
We've had fun with this
show. We had a lot of fun.
We had a lot of fun with this show over the last few months, but this could be it right here. It's very short. Short clip.
It was wild. It was a really cool crowd of London, and, you know, everyone had fabulous clothes on and crazy makeup, and we just had a great time.
It's always just about it's having a great
it's
time.
It's the exact same description, anything shows.
Everything
is awesome. It's awesome. It's fun. I love you guys.
First. Someone's suggesting they probably were telling her the speed in kilometers per hour that she was in, but just couldn't understand.
We're doing like 200 somethings.
She probably couldn't understand the concept of K over miles per hour. I love it. It must be so fucking cool to go through life like that. Like, it just has to be the best thing ever.
Yeah, she has
ever.
No worries. No
it's
stress.
Just, where's the next party? Where is it? Where is it?
Those titties are like a backstage pass. She just
was
all access.
Yeah.
Never had to learn anything.
Nope. Oh, what are those pictures of her having sex?
Yeah, what movies
Let me see that.
Body Shots.
Could you turn the screen a little?
Yeah. Some sex scenes from Body Shots.
Oh, my God, you guys.
Very nice.
Dude, how well is that fat kid from Stand By Me doing now, huh?
Yeah, what happened?
Rebecca Romijn.
Oh, getting the pants taken off.
All right.
Tara.
Too
naked.
Much him? None on, oh, there
yeah.
you go.
There you go.
Very nice.
They're flapping around.
That's before the
before
implants.
Before the implants,
oh,
yep.
Boy.
Bam,
wow, we're
bam,
really ending
bam.
The show?
Amazing.
How did that happen?
This show flew.
Oh, that's too bad. Let's say hi to Mandy in North Carolina. Mandy!
Hi, how you doing?
Hey.
I realized through Anthony's impression that Tara Reid sounds a lot like Corky from Life Goes On.
I love Anthony's Tara Reid impression.
Yeah, I can't get enough of it. That's all I got.
All right, thank you.